President Trump's former campaign manager stonewalling the House Judiciary Committee as its first official impeachment hearing turned into a spectacle.
Mr. Lewandowski, is it correct that as reported in the Mueller report on June 19, 2017, you met alone in the Oval Office with the president? I said,
is there a book and page number you can reference me to, please? I don't have a copy of the report in front of me.
Corey Lewandowski never worked for the Trump administration, but that didn't stop the White House from instructing Lewandowski to limit his testimony to what was covered in Special Counsel Robert Mueller's report.
Congressman, the White House has directed I not disclose the substance of any discussions with the president or his advisors to protect executive branch confidentiality. And I recognize this is not my privilege, but I am respecting the White House's decision.
The White House blocked other former White House aides, Rob Porter and Rick Dearborn, from testifying at all.
I think we should call this what it is, an absolute cover-up by the White House.
After slamming the investigation in his opening statement,
as for actual collusion or conspiracy, there was none. What there has been, however, is harassment of this president from the day he won the election.
Lewandowski did acknowledge that President Trump asked him in 2017 to deliver a message to then-Attorney General Jeff Sessions, asking Sessions to limit the Mueller probe and not investigate the Trump campaign.
President Trump was hounding you about when are you going to deliver that message, correct?
Completely inaccurate, Congressman.
Well, he asked you about it a few times, didn't he?
No, he did not.
He'd never asked you whether or not you had delivered that message?
Not on multiple occasions, no.
One occasion, okay? He did mention it on one occasion to you.
I don't know if that's in the reports or not.
Lewandowski tried to arrange a meeting with Sessions at Lewandowski's office rather than the Justice Department.
Well, Jeff and I are friends socially, and I want to have the opportunity to have a meal with Jeff and relay the conversation which the president asked me to ask Jeff to consider giving.
The meeting never happened, and Lewandowski never delivered the message, but he claims the president's request was above board.
You didn't think that was illegal to obstruct justice?
Congressman, the president asked me anything illegal.
But the defiant former Trump aide refused to divulge much more.
Well, then don't ask me a question if you don't want to hear my answer.
My time. This is a House judiciary, not a House party.
Lewandowski's behavior got a rise out of Democrats.
Mr. Lewandowski, you are about like a fish being cleaned with a spoon. It's very hard to get an answer out of you.
While Republicans leapt at the chance to bash the Russia investigation and their Democratic colleagues.
Because this committee has become the search party for impeachment.
And Lewandowski piled on.
I think they hate this president more than they love their country.
He's a relative rookie to Israeli politics, but he's well known in Israeli military circles. Benny Gantz made a name for himself after 38 years of military service, working his way up to become the country's 20th chief of staff. He was raised in the town of Kfar Achim, central Israel, by parents who survived the Holocaust. Gantz led the Israeli military through two wars in Gaza in 2012 and 2014. He left the army 1 year later and waited the required 3 years before entering politics. The move followed that of others in Israel's military, famously Yitzhak Rabin and Ehud Barak. Both went on to become prime ministers. Gantz's party, Israeli Resilience, consisted entirely of candidates who had never served in the Knesset before. To boost his chances of unseating Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, he merged his Israeli Resilience party with two others, forming the Blue and White Party, the colors of Israel's flag. His slogan for prime minister, Israel before everything. Gantz vowed to pursue peace, but mirrored Netanyahu's hardline position on Iran.
On my watch, you will not become a regional power, and I will not hesitate to use force if and when needed.
On the question of the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, Gantz said he wouldn't make any unilateral moves, such as annexation or withdrawal, without a negotiated political process. He vowed Israel would never retreat from the Golan Heights. He took a stand against corruption, promising zero tolerance. It was an attack on Netanyahu, who faces possible charges of bribery and breach of trust in ongoing graft probes. Netanyahu has denied all the charges. In April's election, his Blue and White Party tied Netanyahu's Likud Party with 35 seats apiece. But when Netanyahu couldn't form a government, he called new elections, and Gantz never got his chance to lead. Now he has a second chance after Netanyahu failed to form that government for the first time in Israel's history, dragging the country back to elections. Gantz may not be as charismatic as Netanyahu, but he is seen as untainted by Israeli politics. Even so, he remains a serious contender for the top spot in Israel.
Are you representing that the White House has told you that they are invoking the executive privilege on your behalf today?
I don't believe it's an executive privilege, sir. And again, I think we've submitted the letter for your clarification of what the White House has said.
Well, let me ask
you. It's not my privilege to waive.
Well, I don't think it's anyone's privilege to waive because I don't think it exists, Mr. Lewandowski. I think the whole thing is imaginary. It's like the tooth fairy. You didn't work
my
for the president
are watching.
In the White
Thank
House.
You, Congressman.
I'm sorry.
My children were watching, so thank you for that.
Well, I hope the president's not on then.